Good afternoon. My name is Andreas Scherk. I am the last speaker of the day. And I would like, wait, it's not in the screen. Can I have it in the screen? And I would like to share with you a little bit a framework of thinking that in some way summarizes what we have been discussing in the last 2 days. So let me start summarizing the three models that we see as MasterCard emerging in different parts of the world. There is the in-store contactless NFC that you have been discussing yesterday and today, so you are perfectly familiar with the model. There is the model number three, that is what Paolo just described. So this is emerging in the Philippines and in other countries where there is a very large number of unbanked customers. This is phone to phone. And there is a second model, e-commerce, that I'm not sure we have been discussing very deeply. This is something that is relevant. It's relevant because e-commerce is growing, and so probably customers at some point in time will no longer be happy in having different consumer experiences for shopping in different spaces. Let me quickly go through each of these models, and let me share with you at the end a little bit what is the MasterCard strategy and what is our vision. Let's start with NFC. I mean, probably you have been bombarded in the last 2 days about pilot, about examples, so you know all of that. What is important to me to tell you is that now in Poland with T-Mobile, we have launched the commercial offer. So it's no longer a pilot, it's no longer a small trial happening in some corner of the world. This is publicly available for all the Polish customers. And Poland has been chosen because it's one of the countries where there is the best contactless acceptance, at least in Europe. So this is live, as is live Turkcell with 14 banks in Turkey. On top of that, we have the prepaid program with Orange in Poland, with Vodafone in Italy, that we launched, I would say, the prepaid card at the beginning of the year. We have been able to sell more than 100,000 cards in less than 6 months, and now we are moving to the next stage. And everything, everywhere in the UK is deploying the similar model. On top of that, we have just announced with Docomo, Japan, an agreement in order to assure interoperability. So what is the message? The message is that MasterCard is partnering with the largest operators in Europe in order to win the mobile space business, in order to assure to the banks, to the mobile operator themselves, and to the consumer the best possible mobile payment experience. We believe our strongest competitor is cash. So this is not a game of winning a little bit of share here and there. This is a game to reduce cash that is still very, very large in almost all European countries, and to give consumer a mean of payment that is significantly better, more convenient, easier, safer than cash. This is our goal. This is the second space that I'm not sure we have been discussing extensively. This is about a mobile wallet that will allow consumers to have one-click experience, one-click payment experience in the internet and in the mobile space. This is very, very important because, again, consumers are more and more, for consumers, it's more and more relevant the e-commerce space. And we at MasterCard are delivering this solution, keeping our four-party model. And this is different than some of our competitors. So we don't have the ambition to build a website. We don't have the ambition to build a database. We don't have the ambition to own consumer data. I know that in the previous session there was a discussion about ownership of the customer. So MasterCard doesn't have the ambition to own the customer. We have the ambition to replicate the four-party model in the e-commerce space, providing consumer the one-click experience. And by definition, if this is the proposition, the wallet has to be open to other brands. Because, I mean, you as consumers don't like to go around with two wallets, so you don't like probably to have two e-commerce wallets to shop online, depending on the brand. Last example. Sorry, Paolo, this is a different example. This is the Telefonica one that we are deploying in Latin America. In the previous presentation, there was the description of the partnership. So this is 12 countries. This is about using the MasterCard mobile payment gateway. This is about addressing unbanked population. This is 87 million of potential customers that in the coming months will benefit more and more by this kind of solution. Now that you have seen the three models, you will ask yourself, okay, but what is the future? Should we continue to keep the three models like three different standalone business? Honestly, we believe this is not the case. And we have the very deep belief that at the end of the day, irrespective of the device to access your shopping experience, it could be a PC, a smartphone, a console for games, a tablet, at the end of the day, consumer will like to have a very consistent experience online and in store. And this is the reason because we at MasterCard have identified a single brand, PayPass, for in-store and e-commerce transactions, because we see convergence. So we see one access brand, PayPass online, that will allow consumers to have access to the next generation of payments in-store, through the internet, or through in-store cloud. This is our vision. We have been sharing it with a number of banks, with almost each single telecom provider in Europe and on a global scale. We see very strong support for this kind of vision, and this is because we believe to be leading the mobile space evolution in Europe and on a global scale. Thank you.